Friends, today we are going to discuss about a new topic called Zener diode, and before that I would like to tell you something about a normal p-n junction diode. We can use a p-n junction diode as a switch. How it is acting as a switch? So see the circuit here. That 120 volt DC supply is connected with an incandescent lamp through the diode. Your anode is connected to high potential, cathode is connected to low potential. So this condition is known as forward bias, so your diode will act as an on switch. But in this case, your diode terminals are interchanged, so your cathode is connected to high potential, anode is connected to low potential, so here your diode acts as an off switch. So like that, you can use diode as a switch. Next one is a Zener diode or breakdown diode. So this is a physical representation of a Zener diode. That working principle is Zener effect, which is invented by Clarence Melvin Zener. It has a two terminal, it has two terminal anode and cathode like a normal p-n junction diode. So this is a symbol for Zener diode. So now think, you have a television in your home. In normal working condition, you can watch the movies and the images will be in a good quality. So nothing will happen. But what happens when over voltage comes? If over voltage comes, so there will be a sudden explosion on your television. So how will you protect your electronic appliances from over voltages? The one and only solution is use voltage stabilizer or voltage regulator. So your Zener diode will act as a voltage regulator. And these are the some of the application of Zener diode. So it is a simple 12 volt charging circuit. So here Zener diode is used as a voltage regulator. So irrespective of the voltage, input voltage, your output voltage is constant. The input voltage may go up to 14 volt, but still your output voltage is 12 volt. So your Zener diode acts as a voltage regulator. And next application is transformerless power supply. So in transformerless power supply also the Zener diode is used. And SMPS, switched mode power supply. Inverter, DC to AC converter is known as inverter. So here also the Zener diodes are used. So what are the major difference between normal p-n junction diode and Zener diode? In normal p-n junction diode, the p-type and n-type materials are joined together. It forms the depletion region and also it forms the p-n junction. And this is a representation of Zener diode. It also has P and N type material, and look at the depletion layer. So here the p-n junction is slightly doped, so the width of the depletion layer is very large. But in the case of Zener diode, it is a heavily doped p-n junction, so width of the depletion layer is small, that is in the order of few micrometer. So that is a major difference between p-n junction diode and Zener diode, because Zener diode is heavily doped, p-n junction diode is lightly doped. And this RBDV means reverse breakdown voltage is greater than 6 volt. It is for p-n junction diode. So it is BDV, breakdown due to avalanche effect. But here that RBDV is less than 6 volt and BDV due to Zener effect. That is a major difference between p-n junction diode and Zener diode. Normally the width of the depletion layer is inversely proportional to doping. So this is a physical representation. So during forward bias, it behaves as a normal p-n junction diode, but the use of Zener diode comes in the reverse bias condition. So we need to operate the Zener diode in the breakdown region. The application of Zener diode comes in the breakdown region, and we can design the Zener diode as a particular breakdown voltage, 2 volt, 4 volt, 5 volt, up to 200 volt. We will discuss in our future lecture. So avalanche breakdown and Zener breakdown both are occurring in reverse bias condition. So next class, we will discuss about Zener breakdown. Thank you.